Hello everyone, today I'm going to be showing how you can access our eLibrary or digital content from home with just your computer. No tablet, no streaming device required. In this example, we're just going to do it all from the computer. So to begin with, I have my computer on and open, and I'm just going to open a web browser. In this case, I'm going to use the Microsoft Edge browser. Only because I usually use Chrome and it stores all of my passwords and logins, and I want to show you just from a ground level. So we're going to open up Microsoft Edge. And I'm going to go to the library's homepage, that is seymourlibrary.org. And we're going to be focusing in on the eLibrary. So right down here is this nice tab. And you'll see that it cascades down when I hover over it. So any of these, I can jump right to the database or the site. So we have OverDrive, Hoopla, RBdigital, Kanopy, and Creativebug that will go right to them. eResources are other databases that are available through Finger Lakes. And ReferenceUSA you can get to, but it'll hop you to a page before it. And also at any time, you can also just click the main eLibrary menu and it will take you to this page, which gives a little bit more information about each of these sites. So you can read more about OverDrive. This is a downloadable instruction sheet. You can also go to our YouTube channel and view tutorials, and this is the quick link to the FAQs and help section. And that's the same for most of our resources. So OverDrive, Hoopla, RBdigital, Kanopy Streaming, and then a lot of the other ones down below, including outside resources. I'm just gonna go back up and we'll take a look at OverDrive first. This one is probably the most popular. So we're going to go right out to OverDrive, and this is what it looks like. And then you will just need to sign in. Going to enter a library card number, so and then your PIN. And your PIN is usually the last four digits of your telephone number unless you reset it. You can also contact the library through email at any time if you need to either look it up or change it. But always start with the last four digits of your telephone number because it's most likely that. Okay, so now I'm all logged in and I'm ready to browse for some items. So any of these ebooks, e-audiobooks, I could check out. I'm just going to pick one to show you what it looks like. So we'll go with the Book Jumper. I'm gonna borrow it. You can change the loan period here if you want to. If you know that you get through books quickly, you can choose a quicker time. So say 7 days, 14 days. I'm gonna leave it at the 21 days and just say borrow. And you'll see that I can immediately listen to this now, listen in browser. Or I can download the audiobook, or I can go ahead and close it, which is what I'm going to do because I'm going to show you how to get to that book after you've checked it out. So all I need to do is scroll up and go to this little section that looks like a little stack of books. That will take me to the account page or the loan page. And these are the items that I have checked out right now. So this is an audiobook, and an ebook. And I'll show you what an ebook looks like. I can go right here to read now in browser, click it. And once again, I don't need any other device. I can just enjoy the book from my computer. And all you have to do is click over here to advance the page, or you can click over here to go back. And it's as easy as that. The good thing is too, if I click out of here, it's going to save that spot in the book. So if I go back to read now in browser again, it's back where I left off. And I can continue reading. So you don't have to read it all at once. You can close out of everything and you can go back into it later. I'm going to close down the book and I will show you an audiobook. So let's go with our new one, the Book Jumper. And I'm going to say listen now. It loads up the audiobook. I'll just show you a few features here. These are the different menus. So this will take you to the chapters in the book. If you've saved any bookmarks and any other tips that has here. This is how you make a bookmark, so you can save your spot in the book. This will allow you to set a sleep timer, and this lets you change the speed of the book. So let me see if I can reset it to one. Okay, and I'll play.
Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Book Jumper by Mathilde Glaser. Translated by Romy Fursland. Narrated by Mary Sarah. Prologue. Will ran.
And if I change that speed.
He ran and ran. The island seemed bigger than you.
Hear that it gets a little bit faster.
Oh, and he'd been running for so long, his chest hurt. Across the moor, through the fields.
So if the narrator is a little bit too slow for you, you can speed it up a little bit, or you can go ahead and leave it set at one.
Into the beach, past the graveyard, and let.
And it's as simple as that, and that's how you can enjoy OverDrive from home on your web browser, no need for a tablet or any other device. I'll go ahead and close this out, and I'm going to go back to Seymour Library's main page. And now I'm going to take a look at Hoopla. Hoopla Digital is a great source if you have a Seymour Library card. You can watch movies, you can listen to music, you can listen to audiobooks, or you can read ebooks or comics. So this is a really great resource. When you do join Hoopla, you will need to create an account with an email and password. I've already done that, so I'm just going to log in. But it only takes a few seconds to create your account. So here's Hoopla. I've already checked out a few things, but I will walk you through that process before showing them off. So you can see down here, it shows what's currently borrowed. So I already checked these samples out, and we will look at that later. But for now, I'm going to browse, I think maybe television. I'll just see what's available. And you can see just from me scrolling through, there's a wide variety of entertainment that you can get here. It's one of my favorites, The Great British Baking Show. So I'm going to click there. And I'm going to go ahead and say borrow. And you can see that I have the choice to either play now, or I can click out of here. And I'm actually going to get out of here. I'm going to return to my Hoopla, and that will always be your main page where your loans are. So anytime you're feeling lost or you're tired of browsing, you can return to my Hoopla and it will show you what you've currently borrowed. And so now I'm just going to show you how you can access these different items. All of them are borrowed the same way that I borrowed that TV show. You just have to click borrow and it's immediately borrowed to you. After that, you will just click into the item. Let's see, we'll go with the Alice Network. And it's going to load my book for me. So much like OverDrive, it displays the book pages. What I like about Hoopla, especially for reading in the browser, is that it easily displays how you can change the font for the book. So if I hit that little double T here that shows the font, it will open this page, and then I can adjust the font size so it's a little bit easier to read. And you can also play with the colors if the black on white is difficult for your reading, or if you need softer color. Any of these you can change. If the spacing's too close, you can choose the spacing here. If you want closer margins or further margins, you can just click here. And again, justification and columns. So it's just your way of how you prefer to read. And you can go ahead and play with any of those and adjust it to suit you. I'm just going to say apply. And you can see that now the font is much more readable. Much like with OverDrive, you can make bookmarks here. This is a further menu. It's actually the menu for the book. So you can hop to any of the chapters or check your bookmarks. And then this is just a little search option. So again, you just click the arrow to advance the page or the back arrow to go back a page. It's as simple as that. And I'll go ahead and close out. And again, it will save your spot if you close out of it. Just realized I closed out of Hoopla, so we'll reopen. It'll save that spot in the book so you can return at any time during the loan period. And I'll point that out as well. If you're unsure of when it returns, you can always check right here next to the title. So this returns in 20 days, this returns in 20 days, this returns in 2 days. So movies are a lot quicker. You only get 3 days with a movie. I'm not sure with the TV shows. I think it does episode by episode. And then 20 days for this audiobook. So now I'll show what a comic looks like. Go ahead and choose resume. So this is how the comic displays. And you can just enjoy the comic if you like them. I'll go back again and show how the movie works. So I borrowed Amelie. Just going to click it. And it should immediately start streaming. The quality may depend on your internet at home. Obviously, if you're a little bit slow, it might have more buffering time. But for the most part, it should stream very well and quickly. Just want to go forward a little bit so I can show you what the quality of the video.
Amelia, 6 ans.
So, there you go.
Comme toutes les petites filles, elle aimerait que...
Not going to play more because you'll have to borrow the movie yourself if you want to see it. But essentially, that's how it works and looks on Hoopla. We will preview how TV looks. This should work much the same way as the movie. So let's go. Episode 1, go ahead and play.
Help everyone explore new worlds and ideas. Support your PBS station.
I want to point out, if you are watching it from your computer, wait a minute, ladies. You can make it full screen right down here. You'll see the little box. I'm just going to check what these settings allow you to do. That's probably fine. You probably don't need to mess with any of that. You can turn subtitles on with this one. So if you were having difficulty understanding what they were saying, go ahead and turn subtitles on. We'll just head back to the full screen mode so I can show you that.
Good. This is very good. We have got 12 oven fresh bakers raring to get into the tent with just a mere 30 challenges between them and the title.
Thousands of people applied.
Been quite a while coming.
So there you go. That's watching television with Hoopla. So if you've been hearing about the Great British Baking Show and you haven't seen it, you can check it out now on Hoopla. This will show you how this works. So it is an episode at a time that you can borrow. So you may need to kind of monitor your checkouts, because we do 10 checkouts with Hoopla. So actually right now would probably be a good time to start, and then just only allow yourself to watch maybe an episode a day in order to get through the season. But yeah, that's how it works. And much like, much like the other ones, you get about 3 days to watch the episode before it returns. So the only thing I did not show is a music album. You can check out music here. I didn't go through that, but it works the same way as the others. Maybe I will show one quickly. Let's go browse music, since that's the one category I missed. If you happen to be stuck at home with kids, you probably would borrow this one. Let's go ahead and try Frozen 2. And so you'll see that music is available for 7 days, so it's a little bit quicker than some of the other things, but not as short as movies. So I'll go ahead and say borrow title, and I'll return to my Hoopla. And now you'll see my music is there. So let's do the music first, and then we'll go on to audiobooks. So this is super easy.
Where the north wind,
it doesn't even open anything else. It just streams automatically. So you can actually go ahead and play your music, and you can browse the web. Maybe look for other Hoopla titles while you're listening. So I can leave that playing and actually return to Seymour Library, check out something else. You would want to make sure that your tab stays open, though, which is this. Okay, so that's how music audio works. So let's see how audiobooks work. So I checked out the Gratitude Daily. Again, it gives me the return date. And again, all I have to do is press play.
And welcome to our 21-day Gratitude Daily audio journey together. My name is Natalie, and I'm going to be your guide. And I'm so, so excited. I'm so grateful that you've taken a little bit of time out of your day and
And it's as simple as that. Hoopla is a very simple service, and you may decide that you like some of it more than others. So maybe you're more into the audiobook area, or maybe you like the ebooks. But there is a lot available on Hoopla. Close out of that, and we're going to return to our eLibrary section, and we're going to take a quick visit to RBdigital. RBdigital offers magazines and e-audiobooks. So I think I need to register here. You, of course, would enter your actual name here, but this is our library showing account, so. You'll see that after I registered, it actually brought me to this nice little support tutorial so that I could make sure I know how this works. I'm thinking that I would actually need to get this one. I think that if you want to do audiobooks, you have to make sure that you get the desktop app. Okay, so I've gone ahead and I have downloaded the necessary app for the computer, and I believe from here we should be all set. So this is our collection of e-audiobooks, and then down below are our magazines. So we do have a variety of magazines that you can check out and read from home. Let's see, let's check and see. HGTV. So this is the current issue, and all I have to do is say check out. And I think for now I'm going to say keep browsing. I'm going to go back. I really want to check one of these out too. So see what we have here. Lots of good options. This does not show all of them, so you do have to explore in order to see the full collection of e-audiobooks. I'll grab the Elton John book. I'll check it out. And I'm gonna go ahead and see what this is like. I'm going to go ahead and play now, and you can see that that app that I downloaded earlier opens up in order to play the book.
Macmillan Audio presents Me by Elton John, narrated by Taryn Edgerton with Elton John.
This book is dedicated to my husband David and to our beautiful son Zachary and Elijah. Special thanks to Alexis Petridis, without whom this book...
So you can see that this actually displays each of the chapters that it's going to be going through and reading. And it's as simple as that. You can play and you can stop it. I'm going to go ahead and close that. And I'm going to see... can get to, oh, yep, there we go. So you can see I wanted to go to my account and what I have checked out. So it's this little hamburger sandwich menu over here, and you can either quickly jump to like what's available for audiobooks and magazines. You can view your account here, or you can go to what's checked out, what you have checked out. So just click there and it'll bring you to this page. So you can see there's my audiobook, and then here is the magazine. And I can just say read. It's going to take a little bit to load, again, depending on the speed of your internet provider. But also with magazines, it can depend on the graphics that are in the magazine. So it might be a little bit longer than, say, an ebook, but it's still very quick. So you can see how quickly I'm flipping through the pages. It's a really nice color here. So, yep, reading an e-magazine is that simple. I can just enjoy the content. It does have a print feature over here. You can bookmark pages. And it also has the index here where you can hop to articles. So say, from a small size, I thought that looked interesting. Can just hop right to it. And this shows me how to shop the magazine and what's in there. And that's it. That's how RBdigital works. So we will go ahead and close this down, and we'll go back to our eLibrary section, and we will take a look at Kanopy. Kanopy is a movie streaming service. Again, I already have an account set up for the library, so we're just going to log in. But if you do not, you do need to have an email and set up your password. And here's Kanopy. So much like all the other ones, you can just browse through and see if anything appeals to you. A lot of these are more independent film or documentary, sort of more educational wise. Kanopy does offer the great courses, so if you're into the great courses, this is one of the places to go. But it also has some movies, classics, and popular films. Sometimes you never know what you're going to find on Kanopy, but there's a lot of good options. So here's what they list as popular movies. You may remember Academy Award winner Moonlight here. And we've shown this one. I think I'll just do the bookshop. So we'll go ahead. So here's the main page of it. You can read more about the film, see how long it is, what it's rated. Looks pretty safe. So I'm going to go ahead and say play. And you can see here the, we showed this movie at the library, so it actually saved when we watched it last. I'm going to go ahead and pause it for a second. You'll see up here a number. This is actually your number of credits or borrows. So you get 10 credits a month, so that's 10 films a month that you can watch on Kanopy. There are also options. The Great Courses now allows you to watch the whole series, I guess you would say, of whatever topic you're on, and I think that'll just be a credit for that whole thing. Before, it used to be, you know, each class session, much like how Hoopla was with the TV episode, but now you can actually enjoy that whole course. They also have Kanopy Kids, which we'll take a look at in a minute, and those borrowings work a little differently too. It won't use your credits the same way. So for now, I'll just show what a movie looks like displayed from Kanopy on a browser. You go ahead and play it. And again, you can see that you can add closed captioning and hit the little square to go full screen.
She told me once, when we read a story, we inhabit it. the covers of the books. I like a roof and four walls. A house. She more than anything.
And of course, I'm not going to play the full movie because it's copyright issues. If you would like to see it, go ahead and sign up for Kanopy and borrow it. So, quickly, I'll just show Kanopy Kids. And so you'll see that it actually describes Kanopy Kids. You get unlimited plays in their curated collection for kids. So you don't have to worry about your credits. That mainly just works for the adult, the movie section. You can see the TV series that it offers. So if you enjoy Arthur or Sesame Street, the Berenstain Bears, Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood, all of those are available. They have some of the book readings. So this is really cute and fun. If you like some of the books, very popular Chicka Chicka Boom Boom over here. Yeah. Again, all of this, you don't have to have your tablet or smartphone or a streaming device. You can do it right from your computer and enjoy the great films and kids content. And that's Kanopy. That's all that's all that you need to do to enjoy it. I think the last thing I'm going to show today is our latest addition to the eLibrary, and that's Creativebug. And Creativebug is online video classes, but they're all relating to art and craft videos. So again, to log in here, you need to have your library card. And then you can create an account here, and this will make sure that it saves all of your further information. Oh, let's edit this. I'm going to go see the latest classes. So this is Creativebug. Essentially, you just get to choose what you would enjoy doing. So they have a variety of daily practice videos. So if you wanted to keep your creativity up to date, like exploring something new every day, you can do the daily practice. I'm going to go ahead and click into those because that looks really fun. And then you would just choose what looks good to you. If you would like to learn watercolor lettering, if you want to do mixed media, or watercolor, a sketchbook practice. I think there are some kind of doodling ones. But you can see there's a wide variety to choose from, and you just have to choose what it is that's kind of striking your fancy. Let's check. Daily painting challenge. So you just click on whatever you found interesting, and it takes you to that actual page. Then you can read the level and the hours and the basic description. So this is intermediate. You should have some art background or knowledge before jumping into this. The whole thing will take you at least 7 hours, and then it tells you what this is going to teach you. So this deals with gouache, watercolor, using your imagination, or using a photograph, and also a dip pen and ink. And yep, so this is a 31-day series with easy-to-follow lessons. And there are 31 HD video lessons that you can access anytime and anywhere. And you can also download the class sheet. I like that up here. You can check anytime, one, the chapters for this, two, the materials needed. This is my favorite. So if I choose materials and then scroll down, this gives you everything that you need in order to finish this session, this class. And you can get that all prepared before you start. This would show you if people have, including the instructor, have shared images from it, which they have. The discussion on it. So these are what people are saying about the class. And any notes, which I'm not going to write any notes. You can add it to your watch list to view later, which I'll mark that so that I can show you later. This is the transcript from the class. This is what the instructor says during this video. And there's that PDF again that we saw earlier. And also you can download the transcripts so that you can read them on your own time. So now to show the video, just go ahead and press play. And the video is going to launch. And in this case, there's closed captioning.
Hi, I'm Carolyn Gavin. I'm an artist and designer from Toronto,
and
Canada.
And here's to do the full screen.
I'm going to be showing you what I do on a daily basis, which is painting. I love to paint birds and flowers and bugs. I'm going to be showing you all my favorite things to paint. We'll be working on a variety of media, including watercolor paper and the sketchbook. I'll be showing you techniques on how to combine watercolor with my ink pen and combining acrylic gouache and watercolor. Daily painting is important because it's a practice and a journey, and if you do it on a daily basis, it takes away the preciousness of what you're doing and leaves you time to play and experiment with paint. Favorite material.
And so once again, it's as simple as that. That's how you use Creativebug. You don't need to have any other device. You can just watch it right from your computer at home. And I'm going to just quickly show the one thing that I said I would, which is showing if you save a bunch of videos or classes to your watch list, you just have to go up to your account here. So we're marked with a little S. And then I'm going to go to my watch list. And you can see that that course is saved right here in my watch list. So even if you just want to browse the site, select a bunch of classes that you're interested in, and then go back to it later. You can do that as well. You don't have to immediately watch and stay with it. You can always return to it at any time. All right. I'm just going to return to the library. And I'll just point out a few other features. So that's our main eLibrary content, but there are other options as well. One, we have ReferenceUSA, which is mostly for entrepreneurs, but you're more than welcome to try it out at home. It is a source of business and residential information for reference and research. If I click into it, it'll hop me over to the page. I'm going to say yes, that's okay. And then you'll just need to enter your library card to enter it. And you can just see the kind of databases that it has available, the information that it is. It's not as thrilling as the other stuff where you can borrow information, but if you are looking for data for, say, a business proposal, this is where you would get it. I should have just typed it in. So we're going to hop back to the library page. And I'll point out quickly, the part that says eResources will actually bounce us out to the Finger Lakes library system. This is their databases, which we share in. And you can just look at the variety offered. So one that I like is under Literature and Books. You can check out Novelist Plus. This actually will help you if you're looking for what books to read next. And we'll probably do videos in the future that will show more about what you can do with some of these. And also the Tumble Book Library is great for parents of small children. If you are a family history researcher, if you go under Genealogy and Family Research, that's where you can find access to Heritage Quest. That's a great starting database for finding census information, Revolutionary War records. It's great for starting your family history. And some of the other ones, testing and careers, we have drivingtest.org. So if you are studying for your driver's test and learner's permit, go there. JobNow is a job database. And then vocation and careers. And you can just look through any of the databases and what you're interested in. And there's probably a good site in here that has a lot of information that you might be looking for. The last thing, well, one of the last things we have in here is called Other Resources. So these are sites that are not library run, but we think might be beneficial to some users. Tech Boomers has information for how to use some of those popular sites that are out there, like Pinterest and Facebook and Snapchat and Twitter. So if you don't know much about those sites, but you're interested in it, that's where you'd go to learn about it. Instructables has do-it-yourself projects. That's kind of fun. And Thingiverse is where you can actually either find 3D printing projects that you don't have to create it yourself. You can actually just download it there and then take it to your 3D printer to print it. Or you can actually upload your projects there. So it's just a bonus resources that we think people will find interesting. Lastly, we do have a video library section. And this is for videos that we have actually filmed and shot. You can access that there. You can also just go to our YouTube channel where this is hosted and enjoy our videos that we're going to have there. So that's it for our highlight of our eLibrary and how to access it just from your computer without the need of, you know, tablets or separate apps. You can just do it all from your computer at home. We're going to have other videos in the future that highlight other cool things either from our website or more that deal with these databases and websites from the app perspective. So keep an eye on our YouTube channel, go ahead and subscribe, and we will see you in the next video. Bye!